Okay, I've got another idea for your final project with the game, and a lot of you want to do some kind of sports game. And let me show you a little bit about the math behind. We're going to do tennis, but it's really going to be more like Pong to make it a little easier and doable. But basically, you need some players, and then this player on the bottom, which I've called Player One, he is the player that you will control, and so he has the code that's in him that will respond to keys. He also, and take a look at this, he has two different when the flag is clicked. When you click the flag, he'll forever be listening to the keys. Also, when you click the flag, he'll always be changing his costume so he looks like he's walking. So that's fun. Now, also make sure that you, like when you go down here and click on his info right here, change his rotation to be left to right so he only flips left to right and doesn't turn upside down. That'll be handy. Now, once you've got that, the real star of the show, the person that has to do all the work, is the tennis ball. And the tennis ball, basically, you just want, what I would do is say, put him in, when the game starts, put him somewhere in the middle of the screen. The dead middle of the screen would be 0, 0. So again, I'm in the brain of the tennis ball right now. Now, directions. We haven't talked a whole lot about directions exactly, but let me show you how directions work in Scratch. You didn't think you had to pay attention in geometry, but it's all about degrees. And the weird thing is, it thinks that facing up towards the top of the screen is 0 degrees, facing towards the right is 90 degrees, facing down is 180 degrees, and facing to the left is negative 190, or is negative 90, I'm sorry. And so you could say, pick me some random direction between negative 180 and 180. Now, it's going to be hard to tell just by looking at it, because it's round, what direction it's facing. But once it faces in a direction, it's always going to move. Then it's going to kick off and be take 10 steps or 12 steps or however fast you want it to go. And then if it's touching the edge of the screen, have it bounce. So, boom. I'm going to stop. I'm going to do it again. That time it looked like he picked a direction that was 180. So every time you run it, it's going to pick a direction and then just start moving. And so that time it was maybe 70 degrees. That time it looks like it was about 70 degrees again. That time it looks like it was negative 130. I don't know. But that's the basics of making the ball move. Now, the big thing is when the ball touches the player, he's got to bounce. Now, the thing that's weird is when he bounces, you need to change his direction. So I'm still in the brain of the ball. Let me show you how to change his direction. To change his direction in the motion part. The annoying thing is it has, let's see, it's got change X, set X, change Y, set Y, but I don't want to change his X and Y. I want to change his direction. Ah, here it is. It's this thing called point towards. And that's from the motion tab. Now, but we can't pick. No, hold on, I lied. I don't want point towards. I want point in direction. There we go. Point in direction. Now, if you're going to do point in direction, it has all these things that would let you pick a direction, but you can't pick it right now because it all depends on where he is, what direction he's facing, blah, blah, blah. So you're going to have to do a little math. So to do some math, this is crazy, click on the green operators. And then there's plus, minus, times, divide. I'm going to grab this minus. That minus will fit right there. It doesn't look like it will, but it will. Then you can also, over here in motion, down towards the bottom, you can ask yourself, what direction am I facing? Boop. So you can do some math based on your current direction. Now, here's what's weird. If I, let's say the ball is traveling this direction, that would be maybe 135. When it hits, once it hits, it wants to go that direction. that direction. Geometry class. So it's facing 130, it's facing 135 from here, right? But that means that, so if this is 135, then what's left over here, the supplement of that angle to make it to 180 is 45, unless I did my math wrong. Don't let me do stupid math. Right? Now, so it's facing 135 currently. That's 45 from where it is to 180. And really, that angle right here is the angle that you want from zero to face the other direction. So really, this business right here, the supplement of that of your current angle, your current direction, is the direction you want to face. Was that too much geometry for you? What that means is, in one of these, you can type 180, and then here you subtract your direction from whatever your current direction is, you subtract that from 180, and that's the direction you want to face now. Okay? But you only want to do that if you are touching Mario. Okay, so I just whipped that up real quick. So basically, that ball should, whoops, I missed him. If I would touch him, well, if I would touch him, awesome. He will bounce. Every time he touches me, he sets his direction to be, oh, that's a good one. To be the supplement of what it currently was, and then it's bouncy. Now, the only other thing is you want this other guy up here to be controlled by the keyboard or by the computer. And so in the next video, I will show you a little bit about how that will work.